Anomaly detection. Introduction. An anomaly is defined as a deviation from what is considered normal. Anomaly detection systems aim at finding these anomalies. All companies deal with anomalies in one or the other way, and therefore anomaly detection systems are in high demand, despite the fact that there is no clear validation approach. These systems rely on deep domain expertise. A manufacturing company relies on an anomaly detection system for quality control. A bank relies on anomaly detection to detect fraudulent credit card transactions. Often, anomaly detection systems need to act in real time, and therefore companies are mainly looking for quick and dirty systems. Density-based systems. Density is defined as mass per unit of volume. Density-based systems rely on the fact that anomalies appear in low-density areas. Outliers are isolated. Local outlier factor, LOF. Local outlier factor is a density-based anomaly detection algorithm that was introduced in the year 2000 by Marcus Breunig. LOF compares the local density of a point to the local density of k of its neighbors. By comparing the local density of a point to the local densities of its neighbors, one can identify points that have substantially lower density than their neighbors. These points are considered to be outliers. We will explain how LOF works using a very simple example with 7 data points, A to G, and 2 features, X1 and X2. We need pairwise distances between a majority of these points, and we will use Pythagoras' theorem to calculate them. For example, the distance BD is calculated as follows. BD squared equals 3 squared plus 4 squared. That means that BD squared is 25. BD is a square root of 25 and is 5 units. Following table shows all the relevant pairwise distances. But before we start applying LOF, we need to introduce some new definitions. First, we introduce a hyperparameter k. K is the kth neighbor of a point. In our example, we will set k equal to 3, meaning that only the third closest neighbor of any point is relevant. Looking at the table, we note that the first neighbor of A is D, 5.8 units. That the second neighbor of A is B, with 6.08 units, and that the third neighbor of A is C, with 6.32 units. In a similar manner, we note that the third neighbor of B is D, with 5 units, the third neighbor of C is D, with 4.2 units, and the third neighbor of D is F, with 1.4 units. Next, we define the average reachability distance of a point A as RDA. Intuitively, the average reachability distance RDA of a point A is a measure for the average distance to be traveled by A's 3 closest neighbors, B, C, and D, to get to A. It's obvious that the longer this distance, the more likely that A is an outlier. The intuition can be explained by adding 3 circles. Circle A, with center point A and a radius equal to the third distance of A, which is 6.32. Circle B, with center point B, and the radius is equal to the third distance of B, which means 5. And finally, circle D, with center point D, and the radius equal to the third distance of D, which is 1.4. The circle with center point A and radius C includes the points B, C, and D. meaning that AC points B, C, and D as its three closest neighbors. The circles centered around B and D, however, do not include A, and this confirms that B and D do not see A as one of their three closest neighbors. The same is valid for point C. No need to draw circles for E, F, and G, as it is obvious that these points do not see point A as one of their three closest neighbors. Mathematically, the average reachability distance of a point A is given by the following formula. For k equal to 3, the equation becomes... This formula needs some explanation, especially for what the maximization part is concerned. If, for example, B is far away from A, the reachability distance RDA is simply the actual distance AB, which is 6 units. However, if B and A are sufficiently close, the reachability distance RDA is replaced by the third distance of B, which is 5 units. In doing so, we make sure that RDA has a minimum value of 5 units, and this will smoothen the impact on the overall result for RDA. Now let's apply the RD formula for point A. From the table we can see that the distance AB is 6.08, the distance AC is 6.32, and the distance AD is 5.8. From the same table we can see that the third distance of B is 5, the third distance of C is 4.2, and the third distance of D is 1.4. Now we need to take the maximum of these two numbers. So the maximum of 5 and 6.08 is 6.08. The maximum from 4.2 and 6.32 is 6.32. And the maximum between 1.4 and 5.8 is going to be 5.8. The average reachability distance for A equals the average of 6.08 plus 6.32 plus 5.8, which gives us 6.06. Now, LOF is a density method, while the reachability distances that we calculate represent a distance. The easiest way to convert a distance to a density is to invert the distance metric. Let us define the local reachability density of a point A as LRDA. LRDA is nothing more than the inverse of RDA. For point A, LRDA equals the inverse of 6.06, and that equals to 0.164. The LRDs for points B, C, and D are the same, 0.193, which is logical, as their RDs were the same as well. Now that we have calculated the LRDs, we can calculate the LOF for point A. LOF for point A has in the denominator the local reachability density of point A, and in the numerator we have the average of the local reachability densities of A's three closest neighbors, which are B, C, and D. The equation gives us a result of 1.17. Looking at the result, we conclude that the density of point A is lower when compared to its three neighbors. The question, however, remains if point A is an outlier. Typically, we would flag A as an outlier because the LOF is larger than 1.1. But the domain expert of the business has the final say.